Thus far, we've looked at univariate methods for creating graphs. That means univariate, one variable. So let's take a look at one technique commonly used for bivariate data, bivariate meaning two. So typically, when we start talking about bivariate data, we're talking about two measurements from the same source. In this case, we have pollution index and the deaths. These are from the Finger Lakes region up in New York State over these years. Now, what's being suspected here is obviously that as pollution levels increase, so does the number of dead fish. So what we want to do is create a graphical display to give us a better idea of what these numbers are telling us. So I'm going to set up a vertical axis here, and then a horizontal axis. Now, on the horizontal axis, I'm going to put the pollution index, and the smallest value is a 2.5, the biggest is 11.6. So I'm just going to go by ones. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the vertical axis, the smallest is 130, the highest is 208. So I think I'll start at 100. They'd be 110, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 200, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Oops, that was kind of big. Now, I'm going to make a quick adjustment here, because you notice the distance from here to here, that should be 100, but it's not, because from here to here is 100. So the way we do that is I erase that, and I put this little jagged thing in here. That indicates there's a break in the scale. Okay, so now I'm going to take a look at 2.5 and say, well, gosh, 2.5 sits about here. And 147 would be about here. So I go to 2.5, 147, and put a dot. And that dot represents this collection of data values. Now 2.6, which is real close to 2.5, and 130. So there's 100, 10, 20, 30. That would be about here. And then 8.3 and 210. So 8.5 is there, so 3 a little bit shy, 210. So this would be roughly here-ish. And then, let's see, 3.4 and 130. So here's 3.5, 130 would be about right there. 1.3 and 114. So 1.5 would be there. 114 would be right around here. And then next I have 3.8, which would be roughly in here. And 162, so it's 150, 60, a little bit bigger than 160, so roughly there. 11.6 and 208, so 11.5 would be here. 210 there, so I'm looking roughly something like that. And then 6.4 and 178, so there'd be 6.5. And here's 170, 180, so roughly something like that. Now, this is going to be a little bit messed up in that you can see my scale is not perfect here. When you use technology, it's going to come out very nice. Or if you spend a little bit more care on this, take a little bit more time, you get this scale proper. But what we are seeing looking at this is, in general, it looks like a linear trend, and that linear trend seems to be increasing. As the pollution index, and I need to label these, this is the pollution. And these are deaths. And then I need some type of title for this. So maybe something like Finger Lakes pollution deaths, or something like that. Now, what we're seeing here is that as the pollution index increases, in general, not always, but in general, the number of deaths also increase. That gives us what we think of as a positive. And this does appear to be a linear trend. Now, if we saw a trend that was negative, it would look like this. This is just in general. So as the horizontal axis increases, the vertical axis values decrease in general. And what I'm getting is this negative trend. If we think of a line going through the data, the slope of this line would be negative, hence a negative trend. Here, if we think of this line going through the data, the slope of this line is positive, hence we have a positive trend. Now, there are many other options, but I'll give you just one more quickly here because this is just a kind of an introduction to the idea of scatter plots. We'll get into it much more detail in a future chapter. But suppose I plotted this data and it looked like this. This is basically a blob. Now, numerically, we'll talk about numerical techniques later, but numerically, we may say, gosh, this is may have an actual positive trend. Because mathematically, it picks one up, it'd be very, very weak, but visually, we'd say that there's apparently no trend. So, this would suggest if this was actually like this, if this was a pollution and this was a death, this would suggest that there's no connection between the pollution and the death.